listen, you guys, I hope you all brought your sunscreen with you. Even that, too many ultraviolet rays. I think when it's over 80 degrees, it doesn't matter if it's night or day. Get a sunburn. It finds you. Hello, by the way. I am one happy girl to be back in Philadelphia. And here's a song we'd like to play for you, which I wrote before I realized that I was a lonely boy. Well, I have known you since you were a small boy. And your mama used to say, well, my boy is gonna grow up and be some kind of leader someday. What she had planned. You're a legend in your own time. You are a hero in the fourth life. Playing tunes to fit your rhyme. But a legend's only a lonely boy when he goes home alone. La 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 Love song, but in fact, it's more of a spiritual love song, and the object of the you in it is God, in fact, and it comes from a particular time in my life when I was doing a great deal of seeking, sort of one thing after another, and I was in search of a lot of answers, as I still am, but I've given up on getting most of them. But I did have the good fortune to meet with a very well-known guru, a Hindi guru with a tradition of 4,000 years behind him and many hundreds of thousands of followers. And I had a personal interview with him. It was just me and him and a translator. And I asked him the very relevant question, which was on my mind at the time. I went as deep as I could go. And the translator translated the question to the guru, and what followed was at least a 10-minute conversation between the translator and the guru, during which I imagined that many of the thorny and, you know, heretofore unsolvable problems were being, you know, dealt with. And I was waiting with great anticipation for the answer. And finally, the guru turned to the translator with the answer, and the translator turned to me with the answer, which was in the form of a question. And the question was, do you know John Denver? In every silly response, there has to be a lesson. And I'm still trying to figure out what it is. And I have to answer that I didn't know John Denver, and I still have never met him. So if any of you have gone any ins with John Denver.
Yeah.
We're going to do a song from, that is the title track of my latest album called... Does that mean you've heard it, or that you just... Okay, here it is. One. And now we've got two. Three. And certainly four. In a suitcase tied in string on the high shelf. In the closet down the hall, hidden from myself. Fits of madness, pools of grief, fevers of desire. All human needs remain salvaged from the fire. Some are crumbled, some are burnt, some are torturous. Five times later, here they are. Let us never say, 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 let us never joke for the band, because you can't see that that was a little portable fan. At any rate, I want to tell you a little story about this next song. It's called The Bat Flying Me Face. And it heralds from a true experience I had about 20 years ago when I was carrying my baby daughter into the house from the car where she was asleep. I walked in the kitchen and a bat flew right in my face, which you know they're not supposed to do because they're supposed to have radar and all these things. And so I wrote the song, and it was clever and all that, nice song. And we performed it. We went on tour in the spring to do clubs. We performed it there, but in trying to figure out what songs to do in the show this summer, I had to drop a couple. We wanted to change a couple, and I decided to leave the song out of the set until about 2 weeks ago, as we were just starting rehearsals, the following thing happened. I was awakened in the middle of the night by a sound of what I thought was an intruder in my bedroom, sort of sashaying among the fronds of my potted palm tree. And I turned on the light only to discover that the intruder was in fact after sap or something, not my jewelry. And so I thought, what am I going to do? I've got to get the bat out of here. And I thought incorrectly that if I turned the light on in the hall, that the bat, like a moth, would fly to the light. So I ran into the hall, and I turned on the light in the hall, and then my bedroom was still dark, and then I crouched under the desk, waiting to see what would happen next. And lo and behold, the bat, of course, I'm sure was as scared as I was, and it flew somehow, miraculously, into the hall. I think probably to check out some of my exercise equipment. And while it was in the hall, I slammed the door closed, thinking I was safe at least until I could think of the next thing to do. And there was a beam of light underneath the door, of course shed by the light in the hall, into my darkened bedroom. And that was the only light that was in the bedroom. It was just like in a horror movie. All of a sudden, a part of that strip of light was darkened and blackened. And I don't know how it happened, but the bat came right under the door into my bedroom. And I turned on the light. I just learned, by the way, a few days ago, that bats have collapsible skulls. Isn't that comforting? Anyway, it's funny because a collapsible umbrella has yet to come under my door. But anyway, the bat came under the door, and I turned on the light in my bedroom and looked down at this creature. And at that point, I knew the song was going back in the set.
Fly in the face. Well, I hope to God you don't come out. Fly in the face tonight.
And I come home from a party, and I'm feeling a little space. And I walk on in the kitchen, and I'm about flying the face. Well, the dog come down the chimney, we wait in the fireplace. When he hears that I'm getting a little snack, the bat fly in the face.
Fly in the face. Fly in the face. Well, I hope the bat, he don't come out. Fly in the face tonight.
When the bat, he might not win. Only children know that. But what I need to know from the Lord is how you get the wings on the cat. They say our bat's got radar, and he can fly too fast. But what I am afraid of is that we got another plan. We're gonna fly in the face.
Fly in the face. Well, I hope the bat, he don't come up. Fly in the face tonight.
Fly in the face.
Fly in the face. Well, I hope the bat, he don't come up. Fly in the face tonight.
Fly in the face.
Thank you.
These bananas in my ears. I'd like to invite John Oates to come back and sing a song of his own composition in the soft, lovely blue light of the stage here. And I should be back. I'm just going to go check to see how Pot Roast is doing.
Thanks, Tony. I'd like to thank everybody for coming out tonight. I know it's really been a hot one, and but I appreciate it. You know, we all do. This is really nice. It gives us a chance to do a little bit of something, and playing with Carly and mixing it all up is really something we don't often get a chance to do. So I hope you're enjoying yourselves as much as we are. I'm going to do a little song for you. It's probably not as familiar as a lot of the other tunes we're doing tonight, but it's a song that's always meant a lot to me, and it was a song that we did on our Ooh Yeah album a few years back. It's called Keep On Pushing Love. Little girl, I'm walking down the street. She got a subway smile and a heart in heat. Say, I'm working for your daddy, working for your daddy, working for your daddy all night. Let the boy make a little scene. He got a party with the band, have a hot chick scream. It's a big old dream. Cause every man, woman, every boy and girl, let your love light shine, make a better world, believe it. But when you feel it, yeah, just keep on pushing love. If you feel it, and your heart can't deny it, no, no. Keep on pushing love. If you feel it, and your heart can't deny it, that you'll be right on time. Well, if you keep on pushing, oh yeah, keep on pushing. See the homeless man on his frozen stoop. He gets to walk on by from the business suit. You see it happening every day. It don't have to be that way. I got a bomb for me and two for you. I'll blow your scene, baby, and you can blow mine too. Cause every man, woman, every boy and girl makes your love light shine, make a better world for me. People, when you feel it, yeah, just keep on pushing love. Well, if you feel it in your heart, oh, you can't deny it. Keep on pushing love.
When I was mean to you,
We're going to do a song which is our new single off of the new album. I say R because we are a collective we. And it's a song that I wrote for a dear friend of mine, somebody I was lucky enough to call a friend, Mrs. Jacqueline Kennedy Onassis. And she was as exquisite as you think she was. In person, she was, you know, probably one of the finest human beings I've ever known. And the way she approached her end was with more dignity than you can ever imagine. And she truly is a great role model for her life and the way she lived it and the way she died. And she was just a magical person in my life. She was my editor, too, for the children's books that I wrote. And I wrote this song for her, and I dedicate it to her now. It's called Touched by the Sun.
some of those secrets of yours. Some of those secrets of yours. Some of those secrets of
riding in a car with about six friends, and we were stopped and pulled over by a van of Jamaican policemen, who indeed arrested us because one of the members of our group had a couple of joints on him. Of course, not me. And but we were all arrested because they like to do things in groups in those days. And so we were all put in the van, and just I was the last person in the van, and just as my leg was about to go inside the van, the policeman said to me, "Have you seen The Spy Who Loved Me?" And I thought this was going to provide me with immediate amnesty, and that I would be flying home escorted by red carpets and special treatment, and all my friends would be in jail. Because I thought that he knew that I did the song from them. But I waited for him to say it. And so the policeman said, "You know the character Jaws in the movie?" I was sure he was just kind of, you know, seeing whether or not we were talking about the same film. I said, "Yes, yes, I know the character Jaws." And he looked at me, slightly fondling my jaw, and said, "You look like Jaws." I closed the van door, and off to prison I went.
Nobody does it better. Makes you feel sad for the rest. Nobody does it half as good as you. Maybe you're the best.
I wasn't looking, but somehow you found me. I tried to hide from your love, but like heaven above me, the spy who loved me is keeping all my secrets safe tonight. Inside you, the things keep on running, but
What's wrong? You have your back to the stage. What is your job, huh? Think you're some kind of James Bond character? No, I'm grateful. I'm very grateful to you. And also to the mayor of this wonderful city, Mr. Eddie Rendell. You're very lucky to have him because do you know that I went to school with him? We went to school together in the Bronx and in New York City, and he was a terrific football player and I a lowly cheerleader, and I used to say intelligent things to Eddie like, boom, get a rat trap bigger than a cat trap, boom, get a cat trap bigger than a rat trap. So I figured to make up for that, Eddie, I'll dedicate this next song to you.
We close the book and lock the door. I believe in love. Thank you.